As people get old, they lose the ability to use their hands effectively. Everyday tasks like buttoning a shirt, tying shoelaces, holding silverware to eat, or even using your touchscreen tablet get extremely challenging. The goal of my dissertation is to find out why this happens. What changes in the nervous system as people age? A little background. Movement of any kind is accomplished by the action of muscles. So say you like to play solitaire on your tablet, like my father-in-law. You need to press and slide in order to move the card. To do this, you use your index finger, your wrist, and your arm muscles. And all these muscles need to work in sync for this action to happen. In order to move, muscles get directions from the brain, the spinal cord, skin receptors, and a number of other sources. And all these signals aggregate onto nerve cells called motor neurons, which then delivers the signal to the muscle. So the motor neuron is the final common pathway that transmits all neural information to the muscle. And there are several of these active at a given time. The signal a muscle receives depends on the number of motor neurons that are active and the rate at which they fire. Now, as people age, these motor neurons start to die off. So the number of messenger cells decreases. The cells that are left behind need to do the task to the best of their ability. So they modify the way they deliver the signal to the muscle. And this is what we are interested in looking at. Motor neuron activity is obtained by looking at muscle activity using a technique called electromyography or EMG. Sophisticated algorithms are then used to extract motor neuron information from this EMG signal. Until very recently, this was done by inserting fine wire electrodes into the muscle to get a close look at muscle activity and get motor neuron information from it. This is as painful as it sounds. Besides, the electrodes need to be inserted at precise locations in order to get any meaningful data. And since the electrode contacts the muscle at a single point, you get activity from just one motor neuron, and all the other motor neurons are not accounted for. A new technology uses multi-channel electrode arrays. These arrays can be placed on the skin overlying a muscle. Each of the little circles in the picture here represents an electrode in itself. So you get EMG data from a large area of the muscle, and you can get activity from several motor neurons. This technology has been validated to get motor neuron information from young adults. We will use this technology to get motor neuron information as young and older adults do some simple hand tasks and compare motor neuron properties to see what changes as people age. The results from our study will be used to design rehabilitation protocols that will help older adults retain and improve hand function. Thank you.